Okay, so making a mono print and clean up. So today we're going to start printmaking, making mono prints. And at my big table in the middle of the room, I have paper that looks like this. And without the supplies on it, you can see that I have traced around items so you know exactly where things should go. The end closest to us in this picture is where you're actually going to print. You'll find a blue bin with printing plates, an area for your mark making tools, and another area for your ink. At the farther end, that's not very clear in the picture, you will see that is the spot where you're actually going to make your print. So it'll have a spot for you to place your printing plate. And up above it will be paper for you to use. There's also a little reminder cloud that is going to remind you to put your name and room number on the back of that print before you put it in the dry rack. So here we are at the start of the printing process to make your mono print. And you can see it says place your printing plate here, and I have my clear printing plate over that, and I have two colors that I'm using, yellow and orange, and there's the blue bin that has some other clean printing plates for another person to use. In the back there, I have a tray that has my mark making material. So the first thing you're going to do is squeeze out just a very small amount of your ink or your paint, and you don't want to have too much because it's going to make a big mess and your print will not come out very well. And you don't want to have too little. If you have too little, your print will come out very light. So it's kind of like Goldilocks. You want that Goldilocks amount where it's just right. And I'll help you with that. Now you're going to take your brayer, and yes, that is the correct terminology for that roller. It is called a brayer, and you're going to roll it out. And if you look in that one picture, you can see I do not roll it to the ends of the whole printing plate. So you're just going to roll it out and probably leave a nice border around there, maybe an inch border or so. And then you're going to put your brayer back on the tray. Now it's time for the mark making tools, and you're going to press the tools, draw with the tools, whatever you would like. You can make a picture of something, you can make a abstract design, just playing around with the material, anything you would like. So here's how my printing plate came out, and I made mine more of an abstract design. I just liked playing around with each mark making tool to see what I could do with it. Now I'm taking my printing plate to the other end of the table, and it says make your print here. So I'm going to set that down on that square, my printing plate, just like you see in the next picture. And right up above it, I have the paper ready for you. So you're going to put your name and room number on the back of that paper, and then you're going to line it up on your printing plate to print. So you've lined the paper up, and you've taken both hands and rubbed over it. What you're doing with that rubbing is you are transferring the ink or the paint onto the paper. And now I think I've done it well enough, and I'm going to peel it back to see what my print looks like. I didn't show you what my print looks like in this show, but it came out really nice. I'll show you in our live demonstration. You're going to take your print and put it in the dry rack. You can clean off your hands if necessary. Well, you might want to do that after you clean your plate. So this is the other side of my table, and this is the cleaning station. And you can see, just like on the other side, It tells you where to put things, tells you where things go. So you're going to set down your printing plate where it tells you, and I have toweling and a water bottle. Now, when you spray your printing plate, you want to do maybe two or three sprays. You don't want to have it soaking wet where the whole paper around the printing plate is soaking wet. Just wet that enough. You don't want it too much. And then you're going to take toweling and wipe it off. Now, you might have to do this twice, but that's totally fine. Just do not overuse that water. When you're done cleaning the plate, it goes back to that blue bin where we saw in our first part of our show here. So this is really just a review of what I've been saying is once you're done cleaning your printing plate, you're going to need to take it to the blue bin because that's how it's ready for the next person to use. I did not show you this in the video here, but you are going to have to clean the brayer too. I haven't quite decided where that's going to be. I'll probably have a bucket at the sink, but I will show you that in the live demonstration. Cleanup is really not the funnest part of an activity, but it is a very important part of an activity because this is how supplies stay nice and how they also are ready for another person to use, just like it was nice and easy for you to use these materials. And lastly, just a reminder, your prints go in the dry rack, and please don't forget to put your name and room number on the back, not on the front. We want to make sure that everyone gets their print back. So have fun, and I'll see you at the live demonstration.